Hi, it's Lori Ballen in Las Vegas, Nevada, and today I'm going to make you a video about the settings in KW Command. As I was completing a blog post yesterday, I noticed that for some reason, since I started this new blog and channel, I had never talked about KW Command settings. So I think it's important that we go through this today. So up here, there is a drop-down arrow. And you can access settings. You're going to want to make sure if you are just getting started with KW Command that you go through these settings and set everything up for the first time. And then you can come back and set up more integrations later. Now, this top part here where it says more integrations, you can connect more apps by going to the KW Marketplace. If we click that, it opens in a new tab or a new window, so our spot is still intact. And from here, you're able to browse the KW Marketplace. And this is something that we are going to see continue to grow, and there's going to be integrations in here that we can bring in with KW Command. So for now, what I'm going to do, I think some of these, let me just check that out. Yeah, some of these are going to be more like they're just third-party access, not necessarily connecting directly with KW Command, okay? Where some of these integrate with KW Command directly. And those are in here, and they would be DocuSign. So I am assuming that most of you have gotten on board with DocuSign because in order to get paid now, with KW Command, we have to be using opportunities. And in opportunities for digital signatures, DocuSign was the chosen integration. So some of you might have kept with .loop, and DocuSign is the connected app inside KW Command. So if you haven't already done so and you want to use it, I'm already connected, so you can see my email here. But if I was not, you would just click connect. Next, we have Facebook post scheduling. Now, you're going to notice as we go through this that Facebook is in here twice, as is Twitter. One is for your post scheduling, and the other is for your ads, where you're going to manage your paid ads. So you're going to go ahead and connect your Facebook, and it's going to be your Facebook business pages. So you do have to have a Facebook business page to connect with. Next, you have Twitter, and you're able to connect that as well. So you would just click connect and follow the instructions. It's very easy. Next, we have Google Calendar. Now, I am going to highly suggest that you use Google Calendar. And let me show you why. I'm going to open contacts in a new tab. And let's just say that I want to go ahead. I'm going to pull Tinkerbell up here. So we're not giving away somebody's phone number using a contact. Okay, so I want to have an appointment with Tinkerbell. All right, Tinkerbell wants to sell her house. So on the right-hand side over here, I am going to click Add Activity. Yep, nope, sorry. I was just making another video, so I had to think for a second. I am going to click on the little plus sign. And then on the bottom there, we have the calendar. This will open the calendar for me to view it, but this is what I was looking for, is I want to actually schedule a calendar event. So when you click here, what it does is it opens your Google Calendar, and it automatically populates for you appointment with Tinkerbell. You can put the time, whether it repeats or does not repeat, and then you can even invite others to that calendared event. And then if I wanted to view my calendar, everything I've got booked, I can view it here as well and use my calendar. So for right now, that is the calendar that we are using inside KW Command. So you'll want to go ahead and connect that in your settings. Gmail, again, I don't know where this will go eventually. We do have KW Command email. KW Command email is sending our smart plans. MailChimp is still the integration for mass email, at least as of right now, it's April. And Gmail is for sending the one-off email. So again, if I was looking at Tinkerbell and I want to email If I want to put Tinkerbell on a smart plan, something I've already created, then I would put her on a smart plan, and that's where that KW command email kicks in. The one that we used to use MailJet, that's gone. Now it's KW command email. That is free up to a certain point, so make sure that you review the pricing on that. And then if I click here, though, to email Tinkerbell, it actually opens, let me have that do not display again, it opens Gmail. And then that does not count against your KW command emails. So we have several integrations that are happening with email. So you'll want to go ahead and connect your Gmail as well. Next, we have Twilio. Twilio is your text messaging software. Once again, it is not free, although it's very inexpensive. So what I do is I throw like 20 bucks in the account. Now I'm going through more because we're sending so many smart plans. But I at the beginning, I threw 20 bucks in the account. It uses it. And once it uses it all up, it sends me an email and says, hey, you need to put more money in here. I think it's less than a penny for a text message. You can go to Twilio and look at their pricing. In order to send a text message through KW Command, either through a smart plan or manually or in a bulk text message, you have to connect Twilio. Now, Twilio will not send texts on your behalf without you knowing about it unless you put them on a smart plan. And then those text messages go out. So be careful about applying smart plans without knowing what you're sending. Okay, you're going to want to review those. Pisync. Pisync is a really cool application that allows two databases to sync together and share data, passing the data from one database to the other or back and forth. And Pisync is great for those of you that are still using something like Infusionsoft or Follow Up Boss or another CRM that you have not yet, you're not all in yet on Command, and you're still using some of those features. You can actually sync them together with Pisync so that you have things working and adding tags and flowing back and forth. It can work if you're using MailChimp and you want that integration. There's lots of ways to use Pisync. I've been one of the ones that have been using it. And if you need help with that, my brothers, Jeff and Paul, own a digital marketing company that I founded originally, and they service KW Command. So they build out KW Command websites. They help with the integrations like Pisync and Zapier, importing, exporting databases, syncing databases. I built a bunch of smart plans and they have added them to their store in addition to the ones that Jeff has added. So there's a suite of smart plans. So reach out to them, commandleads.com, commandleads.com. Next, we have our Twitter Ads Manager. So again, if you are going to run ads in campaigns and you're going to include Twitter, you have to have this connected. Next, we have Google AdWords. So if you're going to want to run ads on Google, so when somebody types in a particular search term, your ad may appear, you're going to connect Google AdWords here. If you don't yet have a Google AdWords account and don't want to do that, don't worry about it. None of these are required. They're only required if you want to use the specific application. Okay. E-Edge, connect your E-Edge account to Keller Cloud. I never had to do that, but you could do that here. Office 365. A lot of people are using Office 365. And I know some people even talked about how they were using email. I don't use it, so I'm not familiar myself. But that can be connected here as well. Then we have Facebook Ads Manager if you want to run Facebook ads and campaigns. MailChimp. Now, MailChimp, I showed this on yesterday's video when I made a newsletter in KW Command using the template with a MailChimp integration. MailChimp, here's the pricing. So you have free one audience and up to 2,000 contacts. Okay. So if you just have all of your people in one bucket, one audience, and you have 2,000 or less, the account's free. If you have More than that, you can go up to 50,000 with three audiences, and you'll be paying $9.95. And if you look here, there's some other differences too. See where the check marks on what are included and what are not included. So you don't have all the pre-built templates in the free version, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So make sure you know what you're doing if you're purchasing MailChimp, but it can definitely be an option for those of you that still want to send bulk email to one group audience. Okay. And then command email, you definitely have to connect this if you want to send smart plans, because your smart plans are going to go through there. Now, if you click on manage, you can type in your sender name, your reply to email name. And then this is nice here. It tells us how many emails we have sent out of that monthly plan. Now I'm recording this, we just started the month, so it's brand new month. But this will keep track of how many emails I send out of that 5,000 that are automatically included. And then if it looks like I'm gonna be hitting that number, I can go to manage subscription and I can pay for the next up number if I want to be sending out more emails than that, okay? We're just now really starting to get everybody on smart plans. So a lot more emails and a lot more text messages for us. On the left-hand side here, you have command settings. And in command settings, you can manage your applications. You can archive contacts. You can wipe your database. You can add custom tags and custom fields. So those are your selections there. You also can manage your sales pipeline team permissions. So for those of you that want to select agents or enable certain permissions by team member, if you want to allow all team members to create private opportunities, yes or no, can. So this is your team permissions. Next, we have your opportunity archive. Then we have agent sites. So we have my neighborhoods. So these are all the neighborhoods that I originally created. We have landing pages. That's actually the one default landing page. And team data. So you can see here, this is the name of my team. This is our description. And these are the members on my team. Unfortunately, we added Jeff as an admin at one time. And now he's a licensed agent on my team. So I don't really know which one is him. And you cannot yet delete it. We have contacted KW and asked us to allow us to remove those. They don't yet have that ability as of yet. But that's where you do that. Now, let me see. I'm curious. Now that I added him, let me see what pops up on my team page. Lori Ballen team. Okay, doesn't look like anything's there yet. Okay, I'll take a look at that later. All right, then we have import logs, and I have, these are all, so whenever I did my contact imports, these are the import logs, and I could go download the original file. Next, we have connect settings. So that first one has all to do with command, and connect settings is where we have our marketing profile. So this is where you can go in and edit. If you had once upon a time set up your Kelly guide and you went all the way through your Kelly guide and you set up your marketing profile with your photo, your logo, your team logo, your license info, your bio, your contact info, this is where you can edit it. This pops up several times, actually, when you can edit your marketing profile, you're able to access that. But in case you don't ever know, just go up here to the little arrow, click on settings, and then it's on the left right here under connect settings. Then you have, we'll close that, we have global settings. Nothing is appearing there right now. And then command market center settings, same thing, nothing appearing there for me. That has to do, I'm sure, with permissions. Okay, so command is really where all the good stuff happens in here, and then connect is where your marketing profile is, okay? That is what you need to know today about your KW command settings. I'm Lori Ballen, serving Las Vegas and Henderson, here with my real estate team at Keller Williams. I'm also a real estate marketing coach, and creating this 365 days of KW command videos to kind of establish this series of methods that I use in my marketing efforts. So thank you so much for joining me today.